Previously on Whisker Wars.
Jack is the Tiger Woods of competitive bearding.
I've gotten the notoriety from my beard. I'm now turning that into profit.
The commercialization of beards, like, oh, a bunch of guys with beards. Okay, now there's professional beard growers.
The Austin Facial Hair Club thinks that Brian has a better beard than Jack does.
My name's Mike O'Connor. I've got a good beard. I put a lot of time and effort into it.
I'm Mike's beard coach. I met him in Alaska at International Beard Competition. World.
My grooming techniques are secrets.
Beard Team USA will be holding the first ever National Beard and Mustache Championships.
I'm not competing. I want to MC. I get to be on stage even more than as a competitor. It's perfect.
Second place representing Texas, Alan Demme.
And the winner, Arnie Bielefeld.
And win the prize.
Bearding is a sport of growing, grooming, and presenting one's facial hair. With competitions the world over, one nation has long dominated, Germany. But now, Beard Team USA, led by Captain Phil Olsen, hopes to stage an upset at the next World Championship in Norway. Phil's hand-picked team includes Jack Passion, Mike O'Connor, Arnie Bielefeld, and Jack's old rivals, the Austin Facial Hair Club. These beardsmen will have to prove themselves on the U.S. competitive circuit if they hope to stand a chance at the Worlds. This is their story. This is Whisker Wars. The American bearding season has begun. In the wake of the U.S. Nationals, and with the Worlds just months away, the competitive beard circuit is heating up. Next step, the Ohio Championships, which promises to draw top talent, including reigning full beard world champ, Jack Passion.
The competitors are getting more serious. There's a lot more opportunity for guys to come up and filter through the sport. There's also a lot more opportunity for alpha dogs to continue to dominate in the sport and just rack up trophies.
After sitting out nationals, Jack is returning to the beard circuit with the support of Beard Team USA captain, Phil Olsen.
As much as I would call him a team captain, I would call Phil my coach. And, there's definitely an important relationship between a coach and an athlete. And I've learned quite a bit from Phil.
Dayton, Ohio, Jack and Phil meet outside the Ohio Beard Championships.
I was asked if I would serve as a judge tonight, which I agreed to do. My reason for doing that is because as a judge, you can't lose.
I just want to point out that my ticket says Jack Passion, and then in parentheses, the one and only.
Well, good for you.
Phil, I'm going to go inside now and win a beard contest.
All right, but we're not sure we want to go in together. Okay, we go in together, but then we sort of...
Phil, I'll let you go ahead.
Yeah, okay. I go first?
You go first.
Yeah, please.
Phil is eager to have his star player return to competition. But Jack's not the only champion here to compete. Coming off his win at Nationals, Arnie Bielefeld is looking to cement his reputation as a contender.
That dude right there is Arnie. He won the Nationals in Bend, Oregon. I mean, look at the guy,
yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah, it's incredible.
It is.
And the contest has attracted local talent as well.
A lot of good people here. I thought when I came up here, this is going to be a freak show or something, but there really is. There's nobody here freakier than me.
With the World Championships rapidly approaching, regional competitions are a critical opportunity for beardsmen to improve their standing on the circuit. Notably absent from the Ohio Championship, the Austin Facial Hair Club. Though it takes them off the competitive bearding circuit at a critical time, the city of Galveston has invited the club to make a special appearance at their Dickens Victorian Costume Festival. It's a chance to raise funds to get them to Norway for the World Championships.
Have you heard about it? Beard and mustache competition today?
The beard contest, it's really just
kind of a prop to get people to like, oh, well, what are you doing? And we're like, oh, okay, so we're, you know, we're the Awesome Facial Hair Club and we're trying to get to Norway, so we're trying to collect donations.
But to a public unfamiliar with the sport, it's a hard sell.
Howdy, folks, you want to help us represent Texas and Norway?
We're going to be selling our merch, t-shirts, koozies, posters.
You should come back. We'll save a shirt for you, bud. The people at first, they're a little standoffish. They're like, what's going on over there with all those guys with beards?
And without the support of the people of Texas, the Austin boys won't make it to Norway.
Hey, guys, have you heard about the beard and mustache competition that we're hosting?
Nope,
soon?
Sure ain't.
Do you want to enter? All right. That guy dressed up as a typical prick.
Across the country in Brooklyn, Mike O'Connor is preparing to host the next circuit event, the Big Apples Beard Championships. It's a chance to establish himself and New York as major players in the bearding world.
I definitely want this to be a major stop on the beard circuit. I mean, you know, there's competitions all over the U.S. all the time, and what better place to have one than in New York? You know, it's the city of cities.
And then we have Judge Badges.
Supporting Mike in his ambitions, his longtime girlfriend and beard coach, Carolina. Mike and Carolina met at the 2009 World Championships in Alaska.
I had found out about the World Championship through a friend of mine.
I've decided to just go and sort of participate, and I met this guy.
I was living in San Francisco at the time, and for me to get away and realize, like, I'm not doing the things that I want to do, like, you know, I want to live somewhere else, I want to just try something different. And she said, you know, if you're serious about moving to New York, like, we got room in the car.
Approach was when we kind of got to know each other more. But then when he got to New York finally and he was here and I knew he was actually kind of staying in New York for a little bit, that's where the sparks flew and...
It totally changed my life.
The competition isn't the only thing on Mike's mind.
The other big thing that I'm worried about is the big surprise that's gonna happen, and that's me proposing to Carolina. Which is going to be awesome.
You know, as ridiculous as it sounds to actually propose to somebody at a beard competition, I just can't think of any other way, you know, except for maybe hiding it in my beard and making her pull it out at some point.
Back in Dayton, the Ohio Championships are about to begin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the full beard natural category will be judged on length, density, and natural pattern.
Density is a product of the amount and thickness of individual hairs. Hair has a maximum terminal length, which can be increased with proper care. Natural pattern is a combination of color and texture.
All right, is this every single full beard natural competitor?
Excuse me, I need to get in there, guys. Excuse me, 1 second.
First up, the reigning national champ.
My name is Arne Bielefeld, and there's not really much to say. It grows. Let it grow.
Arnie's beard is nearly 3 feet long, while rookie Mike Scanlon measures in at over 5.
I'm Mike Scanlon. Last time I shaved was I was up on a machine gun charge down in Cincinnati a long time ago. This is what happens when you get tired of brushing it and you ride and spend a whole lot of time on a Harley Davidson.
Yeah!
And the only thing I do to it is pee on it occasionally.
I used to brush it out and I finally got really tangled. I said, the hell with this. And I just never touched it again. And it did this all by itself.
You know, dreads are dead hair that you don't brush out, and I guess I was schooled in the European tradition.
Jack's beard may not be the longest in the room, but it's renowned for its color and density.
My name is Jack Passion, and my beard has taken me to 2 world championship titles, which is a high honor. Thank you. And you know, bless your hearts. You don't play to lose. And it's, you know, people talk about having a good time. It's not fun if you lose.
Coming up.
We have a tie, first place, full beard natural.
Prominent men have prominent whiskers.
Exactly.
Here's to the bearded and the dandy.
Nice.
Cheers.
And I've been looking at your site every day for about 6 months.
Right? Oh, really?
I think I'd like to grow one out.
Well, you know,
see what I can do.
Finally, you're going to grow a beard. It's kind of interesting. He says he has my picture on his nightstand, which is flattering, I guess.
Kissing booth! Who needs a kiss? Come kiss the mustache of your dreams!
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much. You. We really appreciate it, guys. Right. Helping us go to Norway.
The Ohio Beard Championships. With the competition coming to a close, two competitors have perfect scores and the judges are deadlocked. Though Phil Olson has already made his decision.
It's not a contest to see who has the longest beard.
Length, fullness, right?
Fullness, pattern.
Pattern, natural pattern and texture. Personal fit.
Yeah, I think Jack wins all of those except length.
This is our
After a lively deliberation between Phil and the local judges, a decision is reached.
In third place, we have
Feather Hat!
Had a close, close tie for first place. So,
in second place, Mike S. And in first place, Mr. Jack Passion.
Sir.
First place and your hand-painted stein.
Thank you so much. I'm stoked. I didn't know what to say. I didn't know how things were gonna go. I did a good job, and I feel good.
So at the different events, you always have that mystery element of a local beard showing up.
Phil Olson was a guest judge. He was kind enough to grace us in the judges panel.
His wisdom, I think, helped us a lot, especially when it came down to the tie for the natural beard.
We were split.
He definitely was the nail that helped Jack win it.
Well, we got a few more contests to go until Norway.
Jack's got the greatest beard in the world, as far as I'm concerned, but there's some pretty stiff competition. He needs to look out.
Always a pleasure. Thank you again.
Pleasure too.
Back in Galveston, Texas, Austin's fundraising efforts have met with little success, and they make a final push to rally the people of Texas to their cause.
Everybody! Ladies and gentlemen, this is the face of Team Texas in Norway 2011. These are your homegrown local boys. We're selling merch to help raise money to make Texas known as the beautiful country it is to the rest of the world.
Texas is the place for facial hair. I mean, it is. So if these guys from Austin, Texas are gonna go represent us, then we're all for them too.
Is this real?
It's real.
Wow.
Koozies are $3, but you get two for $5. So you get one for you and one for your special friend. We've got people coming all up, shaking their hands, getting photographs, really wanting to help us get to Norway.
We brought the kissing booth.
I need kisses. Do people in Galveston like to kiss?
Kiss this bearded
beauty. Yes, sir. Oh, we get the kiss?
Of course.
Yes.
Hey, girls, $2. Somebody's got to pay the man.
Thank you.
Our current campaign to get to Norway has been going very successfully. This event probably put us $1,000 closer.
I'll get to a pink and a blue.
Pink and a blue.
With their fundraising efforts starting to pay off, the Austin boys can focus on the real reason they're headed to Norway.
Everyone would love to see the current reigning two-time champion dethroned, and that's Jack Passion. I think we're representing Texas a little bit more than Team USA.
In Brooklyn, Mike O'Connor makes final preparations for the New York Championships.
I think he's gonna be a fantastic host. He might be a little bit nervous in the beginning,
but I think that he's gonna be great.
I'm still trying to figure out how I'm gonna do this whole thing. So there's a lot on my plate right now.
Mike's got more than the competition on his mind. There's also his upcoming proposal.
I almost forgot it.
The New York Championship has attracted many circuit regulars.
We keep challenging Jack. Getting closer, and like I said, there is potential left in this beer. It's not done yet.
I hope you take Jack down.
One of these days, we gotta work on it.
All right.
It's Arnie's second chance this season to take down the world champ. And as always, there are also local challengers.
Jack Pash is my rival. I wouldn't say rival, we're competitors.
Trevor was really upset a couple years ago that I beat him. I know his friends don't like me, and they're here tonight, and I don't care.
And as in Ohio, Phil Olson has been asked to judge.
That is the New York City Beard and Mustache Competition.
The competition in each category is fierce, but as always, the main event is full beer.
All right, we are ready to begin the full natural beer category. Let's go. Number 23, the national champion, Arnie.
Yo, Woogie.
Next up, we have number 21, Trevor.
New Yorker Trevor Cranmer is a favorite of the hometown crowd.
All right, next one, step forward. Where's your face?
Brian Redbeard is a rising star on the circuit with color to rival Jack's.
We have the reigning world champion in the natural beer category, Jack Passion.
Passion gets a mixed reception, but it's the judges who will choose the victor.
We're gonna deliberate, we're gonna come back with our results. We'll see you in a little bit.
People do passive-aggressive things and tell their friends to boo. But you know, when I was a young boy, it was actually my mother. She told me, it's an old family tradition of what you say in a situation like that. And I'd like to share it with you now. And it is f-em.
Backstage at the club, the judges tally the votes.
I'm abstaining in the full beer category, and there's a reason for that.
And it's just making sure that it's fair. Okay.
Excellent. That's fair a enough. Great Everybody's idea.
Yes. Totally.
Okay.
You want to be fair.
Hoping to avoid perceptions of favoritism, Phil recuses himself from judging Full Beard.
Mike, I am now handing you the official results, and I'll ask you to announce the winner.
In moments, the night's most anticipated results. A win here could provide critical momentum going into Norway. And later.
All I got is one question for you.
The New York City Beer Championships. The crowd anxiously awaits the results.
Here's what you're waiting for. In third place, full natural beer category, we have Mr. Brian Redbeard. That's an amazing beard. Number two in the full natural beard category, we have Mr. Arnie. Heel bounce. Come on up here, Arnie. In first place, we have number 100, the Jack Passion, bringing that amazing beer, Big Red.
It's Jack's second title in as many weeks. Though national champ Arnie Bielefeldt continues to nip at his heels,
Ladies and gentlemen, these are the winners of the full natural beer category.
With the competition coming to a close, Mike has just one final announcement.
All right, real quickly, I actually want to bring Caroline up here. We met in 2009 in the World Beard and Mustache Championships in Alaska, and she is the reason why I am here today. She is the reason why I'm putting this, the whole thing together. She has been very, very solid. I wouldn't be able to do this without her, so all I got is one question for you. And one question alone. Carolina.
Coming up.
One question. Yeah. Are we supposed to be sweating? Because I'm sweating profusely.
With back-to-back wins, Jack is back on top of the beard circuit. But Mike and Carolina are on top of the world.
So overwhelmed right now. It's amazing.
While Arnie already has his eye on the next competition.
I'm proud, of myself, my beard. Jack Roots, we'll see you at another event soon.
And Austin celebrates their successful fundraiser with a beard-rejuvenating, follicle-stimulating spa session.
One question. Yeah. Are we supposed to be sweating? Because I'm sweating profusely.
You're supposed to sweat it out.
And people go like, this is enjoyable. Are we enjoying this?
This is like something I really enjoy doing.
We're all ready for this competition?
The official regionals, yeah. Is that what it is?
West Coast regionals.
I'm going.
Next stop for our competitors, the West Coast Regionals in Portland, Oregon.
It's a regional.
Okay, just leave that.